competitor then could afford the loss. Some question now if Lockridge can afford to lose this bout. Not an old man by any means, 24, but title shots don't come easily when you've lost two of them. So this could be a make-or-break fight for Rocky Lockridge from Maple Shade, New Jersey, originally of Tacoma, Washington, the number one WBA featherweight contender. And having seen some other number ones as recently as 3 weeks ago in Atlantic City, we could say that Rocky legitimately is a top-ranked contender. Pedroza's had 39 bouts, though. Lockridge, 29. And at the weigh-in today, they'll come out now for round one. We'll tell you about that in just a moment. It was very tight for Pedroza, just getting in at 126. For Lockridge, he came in light, 122 and a half, and that's only a half pound more than the super bantamweight class. Nobody can explain at his party why Rocky came in so light. Pedroza normally starts a fight very, very slowly. He has three gears. He goes into low for five rounds, shifts to second for five, then right up to high, and he's won many bouts. In fact, he has knocked out seven opponents from the 10th round onward. And he can hurt you with punches to the body. Now, Lockridge indicated he would come in here trying to take it right to Pedroza early because he knows Subio lays back in the early rounds. They've got a minute now into round one. It is scheduled for 15. The referee, Ove Ovsen of Denmark, gets to score the bout along with judges from South or from Korea and from Argentina. This referee, Ovsen, is officiating in the ring in his first world championship bout. The first time they met, Pedroza was warned for half a dozen low blows, so we suspect it'll take a very strong referee to handle this one as it goes along. And we certainly do not look for any early knockouts here. Approaching the two-minute mark. Very sparse action. Pedroza, the taller man, has a height advantage of 3.5 inches, a reach advantage of 2 inches over Rocky Lockridge. As we're inside the final minute of first round action, overhand right missing by Lockridge. Rocky has not come on as strongly as we were led to believe, although it is just round one. That was his strategy. And then to start to move in the middle rounds of this 15-round bout. Lockridge banging away to the body now, trying to get inside the longer arms of Pedroza. Pedroza, as we have told you, a fine body puncher himself. So the seconds wind down here. The first round scheduled for 15 in San Remo, Italy. Two in San Remo, a fairly even first round, fairly sparse action. Much of the punches were to the body from Pedroza and Rocky Lockridge. This is the rematch of their bout a little more than 2.5 years ago in New Jersey. And it was in that bout that Lockridge did pile up an early lead, and Pedroza came back so typically of him in the late rounds and won the split decision. USFL final score, Tampa Bay 30, Washington 23. Another tough loss for Ray Ox's team. And this indeed would be a tough loss if it does occur for Rocky Lockridge. Second title opportunity. Champion Pedroza, one of the most respected boxers in any weight division. The obvious favorite here. Frankly, Lockridge has not shown the aggressiveness that we were led to believe he would display in the first round. A little more tentative than we thought he might be. A minute into round two. Lockridge flicking out the jab. Now he works to the body of Pedroza. Midway in the second round. Lockridge beginning to come on a little bit more now. But Pedroza is so skilled defensively. Very flexible from the waist up. You get him in corner situations like this, he'll behave like a jack-in-the-box sometimes, popping up and down. Very, very hard to hit. The referee from Denmark, Olvesen, is among the spectators, although he's got a good view in the ring. He's very, very lenient now, letting him tie up, standing well, well back of the action. Still lets them brawl in there, finally calls a break. It is the referee's first world championship bout. And he's got his hands full with Pedroza. He's given referees around the world fits over the years in his 16 title defenses. This is the 16th in 5 years. Some questionable tactics have been used by him. 30 seconds to go on the round. Again, a good body combination by Rocky Lockridge. Couple of bulls instead of making the other back up in these early rounds. Just a few seconds left now. The second round scheduled for 15 here in San Remo with a flurry by Lockridge. This is the third round in San Remo. Lockridge with an edge in the second round, the more active of the two after an even first round. Again scheduled for 15 WBA World Featherweight Boxing Championship. This man, Pedroza, may be unofficially regarded as the universal champion of his weight class. He holds a victory over Laporte and has been simply unstoppable through 5 years. His reign is WBA World Featherweight Champ. Young Lockridge, just 24. Two losses against him, one to Pedroza, trying to come back in his second attempt to take the title away from this ring-wise veteran from Panama. Laporte is the WBC champion, and he stopped Rocky Lockridge in the second round. And for Lockridge, a devastating defeat. He's had trouble coming back from it. His spot, very uninspiring opponent since that time. This is his first big test since then. In case you missed it, Tampa Bay beat Washington 30-23 in the other USFL game we're keeping tabs on today. But here in San Remo, Italy, the story is boxing. Lockridge and Pedroza. Midway in the third round. Time and time they'll tie up, and the referee, Olvesen, content to let them do that, let them work their way out of it. Very passive man in the middle, and we think as time goes on, it may take a more aggressive, stronger referee to handle this situation. A minute left in the round. No question about Olvesen's integrity, but his experience is wanting here in terms of major fights with difficult fighters, which Pedroza admittedly is. Long looping left, missing by Rocky Lockridge. Referee will score, so will the two judges, and they've got their hands full the way this one is going. A lot of infighting. Very difficult to tell who's landing and who's not when they're in that close. They pull each other around. Pedroza now up against the ropes. He doesn't mind being there one bit. See the head pop down and up again, missing punches. That's the jack-in-the-box technique as Rocky bowls it into the ropes, and a kidney punch thrown there by Pedroza. He loops it around past the ribcage. Now Pedroza throwing the right, pushing Lockridge off, going on now with a combination, and Pedroza coming on earlier than he has in many previous fights here in round number three. Good late action in the third round. Into round four we go, and that late flurry, that tremendous right hand thrown by Pedroza, might have been the difference in round three in an otherwise fairly even bout. The difference between this fight and their first meeting 2.5 years ago is that Pedroza is coming on earlier than before. He really laid off, allowing Lockridge to build a big lead. And despite Rocky's plan to come at him early, he has not been all that effective in the first three rounds. good uppercut throw with the left hand by Rocky Lockridge. But he's having trouble containing Pedroza in that corner against the ropes. Pedroza so effective counterpunching. Coming up short with the right. Looping right by Lockridge, missing. Pedroza's got a classic jab. While he is renowned as a body puncher, he has not resorted to that at this stage of the bout in round number four. They approach the halfway mark, Lockridge with a right. Now the infighting continues. We'd like to alert our local stations along the line. At the end of this round, we'll take a station break. We're watching the WBA World Featherweight Championship on the line in San Remo, Italy. Again, the effective counterpunching of Savio Pedroza. It is early yet, but there will be a question later on if Rocky Lockridge has the stamina, coming in at just 122 and a half, barely above the super bantamweight weight class. Now Olsen moves in to separate them. They begin to tangle it up once again. Pretty much the kind of fight we thought. A lot of infighting, a lot of clutching and grabbing, and it will certainly intensify as time goes on. Lockridge trying to get inside, effective there, just missing with a left hand. And he bangs away to the body of Pedroza. 30 seconds to go, and this is the fourth round. Pedroza is such a fine counterpuncher, he doesn't mind standing right there on the ropes. He can be very effective in that position. We'll return with more of ABC's Wide World of Sports after this from our local station. More aggressive in the early rounds than he has been before, as we have told you. Would have a slight edge right now. The first round even, Lockridge appeared to take the second. Three and four have gone to Pedroza in our view, and now Rocky with a good combination, trying to turn the offense on and prevent the counterpunching ability of Pedroza, but he takes the body shots extremely well and comes back with a body blow of his own. This is a risk that Lockridge has to take. That is to open it up early. If he can be effective, so much the better, but there's always the risk that he will pay the price for it. There is a caution about a kidney punch from Olsen, the referee. The Lockridge camp made a point of the rules meeting with the officials of noting that Pedroza has a habit of doing that, and indeed this referee spotted it very early, though he missed one previously. 2 minutes to go now in round five. The two styles very similar. Flat-footed, not much movement around the ring. This is the kind of a bout that could be a very punishing one with all the infighting, the heavy body punching taking place. And again, as we said, a difficult one for the judges to score. Quick hands of Pedroza showing up there with that snapping lefty through. We are midway and this is the fifth. Benton trains Lockridge now as he throws a good right, and he's worked on his defensive skills. And they will certainly be important as this bout progresses. Less than a minute to go in round number five. Stamina, the question in terms of Lockridge as well. Pedroza has a track record of going the distance, of taking fights well beyond the 10th round. Uppercut thrown effectively by Rocky Lockridge. Two bulls leaning in for the infighting. Plenty of heart on the part of Lockridge. No question, he wants to take it to him. He's been effective there, too. It pays the price for the counterpunching of Eusebio Pedroza. Now, less than 5 seconds to go in round number five in St. Louis. The sixth round, Lockridge and Pedroza. And this one's certainly up for grabs on the Italian Riviera tonight. Now past midnight local time. The second attempt by Lockridge to wrest the title from this champion who's so skilled and so wily, Eusebio Pedroza of Panama. Rocky with a pretty good fifth round might well have won it. He has forced Pedroza to open up earlier than Pedroza likes to. Counter with a left hook. But Pedroza, the master counterpuncher, as we have seen. So when you take it to this man, inevitably you'll pay the price. Pedroza blocking many of those blows. There's the hook getting through again. Keeps the elbows tight to the body, the gloves high. And he's totally expressionless at all times. He won't let you know if you're getting to him. Lockridge's hands getting a little lower now. Pedroza made Lockridge stumble. Snaps another combination through. His best exchange of the bout so far. And now Rocky has to bob and weave and duck out of the way. Bolo punch he tried to throw to the midsection there. Drives the right through. Pedroza with an impressive sixth round underway. Duva, the manager of Lockridge, came right around. You could see him in view. And he was yelling at the corner, the Pedroza corner, about something. Now he has retreated. A minute left in the sixth round. Perhaps he's getting a little anxious now as Pedroza has had the best of it here in the sixth round. Our next Sunday edition of ABC's Wide World of Sports, a week from today, features the WBC World Lightweight Championship. Edwin Rosario and Jose Luis Ramirez live from San Juan, Puerto Rico. That's right after ABC Sunday afternoon USFL coverage. This for the title vacated by Alexis Arguello. And Pedroza has not vacated this title in 5 years. One of the longest reigns among men still active in boxing among the champions. He has had a very good sixth round as the seconds wind down. Scheduled for 15, remember, here in San Remo, Italy, on the Mediterranean. Into round seven we go. We approach the halfway mark of this WBA World Featherweight Championship in San Remo, Italy. Scheduled for 15. Pedroza in marvelous condition. Never shows any expression. Whatever he is, 27, as they say, or 30, as some think. He's a ringmaster. Lockridge will need every skill and every boxing tool available to him to defeat Pedroza today. Rocky acquitting himself well, however, did not get to Pedroza as effectively as he had planned in the early rounds. He planned to be moving at this stage now, but the pattern continues. Lockridge coming up. Pedroza eager to counterpunch with him, and a lot of damage being done to the bodies of both men. 2 minutes to go now in round seven. Advantage of Pedroza hasn't really been a factor. Lockridge able to get inside rather easily. In fact, Pedroza almost welcomes it. Pedroza convinced he can win any exchange of blows once they get inside. They're midway in the seventh round. Lockridge continues to be the aggressor, taking the fight to Pedroza. And has gotten his share of blows in, but Pedroza, as we say, so effective from a counter-punching point of view. The officials will have a very, very difficult time in judging this one based on the style of the fight. No ring movement. They're both flat-footed. A lot of inside boxing going on. Squaring up with their elbows, trying to fend off the other man. There's that jack-in-the-box technique of Pedroza again. Quite content to stay in there. Less than 30 seconds to go in round seven. Seconds winding down to the seventh round as we approach the halfway mark of this 15-round title bout. Don Chevrier back with you ringside, San Remo, Italy, the eighth round of the scheduled 15-round WBA World Featherweight Championship. Eusebio Pedroza on the left, the defending champion against Rocky Lockridge of Maple Shade, New Jersey. Originally from Tacoma, Washington, the number one ranked contender. And despite the aggressiveness and the heart shown by Lockridge, as you see right there, taking the action to Pedroza. Pedroza, you get the feeling he's still in control of this fight. He knows he has the reserve and the stamina, as he's shown so many times in the past. But Lockridge did force him to open up a little earlier in this bout, back in round three, than many thought Pedroza would do. Coming on stronger now, getting a caution from the referee, Olvesen. I'm not sure for what it was. Referee did caution him for a kidney punch earlier. Snapping those punches out so quickly, Pedroza starts to come on now here in this eighth round. Again, for him, a little bit ahead of schedule. Pushing Lockridge off very easily and snapping both hands out so quickly. He was content to fight closer before. Now, Pedroza forcing this action at long range, using his long arms like the right you saw there. Halfway through the eighth round. It's been a good round for Eusebio Pedroza of Panama. Remember, Lockridge came in very light. His camp surprise, 122 and a half. And with the weight that Pedroza could have added, in the 13 hours since the weigh-in earlier today, he could be well up to 130, 132 now, and Rocky maybe barely at 125. That's a big difference at this weight level. A minute left in the eighth round. Lockridge still coming on, still trying to take the action to Pedroza. 30 seconds to go on the round. It appears that both fighters have been doing exactly what their corners have told them, in a good combination, the right then the left by Rocky Lockridge late in this, the eighth round. They are past the midway mark of this bout now as the seconds wind down on the eighth. They go into a ninth round here in San Remo. Lockridge, game as can be, knows he has to fight the fight of a lifetime to win this title, wresting it away from Pedroza. He has done everything that has been asked of him by Lou Duva, George Benton in his corner. But Pedroza, oh so confident, so quick, so well poised in the ring. The experience factor, the biggest asset Pedroza has going for him. He can pace the fight at his own pace.
So
Lockridge pushing him back, trying to hold him in there and do some damage. Snapping the hooks, going down to the body, back up to the head again. Series of scoring blows there by Rocky Lockridge. A minute gone around nine. Rosenau showing a little more movement around the ring. That's why he's so difficult to contend with. The man will change up styles on you, take the lead, sit back and counterpunch, and swing it back and forth so frequently during a bout. I'd like to alert our local stations along the line that at the end of this round, we'll take a station break. Pedroza looked like he was ticking into high gear ahead of schedule back in the eighth round, and now has settled back into the kind of fighter he's been known to be in the middle round. When Pedroza signs for 15, he figures on going 15, and quite often has never lost a bout that has gone to decision over 15 rounds, but has stopped many opponents in the late going. You got to give Lockridge credit. Taking the action to him and has been successful from time to time. 30 seconds to go on the round. Again, we stress how difficult it must be to score this kind of a bout. Referee and the two judges from Korea and Argentina will decide the outcome. If indeed, as it appears it will, it goes the distance. And we'll return with more of ABC's Wide World of Sports right after this from our local station. Into the 10th round we go here in San Remo. Lockridge continues to pursue Pedroza. Pedroza now showing the movement he began to display in the 9th round around the ring. Until that point, both these guys were flat-footed, just wailing away inside at each other. Lockridge, too, with quick hands, using the new advantage here. Rocky Lockridge is now 24, a more mature boxer than he was as the 21-year-old who fought Pedroza to a 15-round split decision defeat in the hands of the champion 2.5 years ago. But then again, Pedroza has that extra 2.5 years of experience. 5 years he has been the champion of this weight class. This is 16th title defense tonight in San Remo. Pedroza is very confusing because he goes into a shell from time to time and then will burst out as he did in round 8 and then get late in round 9. Lockridge has got a shot at it if he can keep the pressure up as he has consistently to this point, the 10th round. Again, carrying the action to Pedroza in the corner. Lockridge works the body, then the head, shoots the uppercut through. Seconds to go on the round. It's been a good one for Rocky Lockridge. No evidence at this stage of Rocky running out of stamina. Just seconds to go in this, the 10th round, scheduled for the 11th round underway in San Remo. Neither man has been down, neither man has been seriously hurt, and certainly not cut here so far. And Lockridge did something in the 10th round that surprised many. He may have won a later round in a bout against Pedroza, and that just doesn't happen very often. It certainly didn't happen for Rocky in the first bout, as Pedroza piled up the late rounds to come from behind and win the split decision. And it looks as though this decision may be equally close here in San Remo tonight. At this stage, the 11th round, the earlier concerns because of his light weight, 122 and a half, Rocky not having stamina, appear to be out the window. Rosa normally is in a high gear at this stage, but has not picked up the pace so far. He did briefly in the 8th and 9th round. And it appeared that Lockridge might have won the 10th. As Rocky sticks to his plan, coming on him, staying right on top of him, and neutralizing the 2-inch advantage in reach and the height advantage of 3.5 inches enjoyed by Pedroza. Midway, and that's the 11th. Good right hand thrown by Lockridge. Again, no expression whatsoever from the face of Pedroza. Lockridge has punished him the last couple of rounds with solid blows both to the body and to the head. A minute left in the 11th round, and the expected is not happening. It is Lockridge now, the later rounds coming on to earn valuable points. Lockridge looking as effective now as he has throughout the bout. 30 seconds to go on the round. And if, in fact, Pedroza has a lead, it surely can't be large enough that he can afford to sit back. Because Lockridge in this round is certainly gaining on him. Down to the final 5 seconds of this, the 11th round scheduled for 15. That was his loss to Pedroza 2.5 years ago. And he certainly is more impressive, a good left by Pedroza there in the later rounds than he was that day. Pedroza's corner obviously is told him to open things up a little bit because Lockridge appeared to win both rounds 10 and 11. A minute gone here in the 12th. That's the way we see it anyway. But as we suggest, it will be a tough fight for the judges to score. Good right by Pedroza. Caught Lockridge on the way in. Pedroza certainly opening things up for now. Lockridge measuring him, clubbing him with the right hand, a glancing blow. Now Pedroza back into his shell, content to stay on the ropes. Here in San Remo, the WBA World Featherweight Championship. It is up for grabs at this stage, midway in the 12th round. The champion, Eusebio Pedroza, laid back early, came on earlier than many thought he would in the middle round, comes in and out of his shell, and Lockridge, who has had two good rounds, 10 and 11, is right back in this fight. Rocky Lockridge, the number one contender, the challenger for Maple Shade, New Jersey. A minute to go in the 12th round. This, the second meeting between these two, every bit as close as the first 2.5 years ago. That was a split decision. This very well might be the same. Although it may not go in the same direction for Rosa. But Rosa has to impress the judges late here because Lockridge has been coming on as the bout progresses. Pedroza hooking well, jamming the left of the body. Rocky keeps coming on for more. Good 12th round action here in San Remo, Italy. This is the 13th round, and it gives every indication it'll go the full 15 here in San Remo. A fairly even 12th round. And a pretty close and exciting fight coming up next Sunday on Wide World of Sports from Puerto Rico. The WBC World Lightweight Championship. The very impressive Edwin Rosario and Jose Luis Ramirez live from San Juan right after the USFL next Sunday afternoon. And this is a dandy right here in San Remo tonight. Pedroza is slipping. Water in the corner there. Helped his feet go out from under him. That's the closest anybody's been to the canvas in this one. Good left hook thrown right there. Lockridge simply will not quit. And he's going to have to be very impressive to take a title away. The eyes of the judges in a bout that is now this close. Certainly appears to be still up for grabs into this 13th round. A minute and a half left, midway in the round. Lockridge has shown the stamina in the late round. Question will be for the judges, has he decisively come on enough to beat this champion, Pedroza, and turn the tide in the late round? A little over two rounds to go here in San Remo, and the question is still in doubt. Neither man slowing down one bit. Good right by Lockridge, following with a partial left. He has scored a couple of those in this round. And it's that kind of domination and effectiveness and power that can sway the judges. He must continue to do it. Lockridge again. Up high, then down to the body. 30 seconds to go in the 13th round. Rocky has plenty left. And if anybody looks a little bit tired, it's Pedroza right now. Quickly with the hands, Pedroza counterpunching late in this 13th round. It's been a good one here in San Remo. Stay with us. Jeff, looking at Lockridge in his corner between rounds. He looked very cool and very confident and relaxed.
Championship boxing, the main event. The undisputed middleweight champion of the world, Marvelous Marvin Hagler, defends his crown against the WBC's number one contender, Tony Simpson. This event was sold out within 24.